In a story about justice being done, an American who hijacked an airliner to Cuba almost 30 years ago has returned back to the U.S. to face justice. According to the Weibo post that cites CBS News, FBI agents took a 56-year-old Williams Potts into custody after he arrived at Miami International Airport. Potts is a wanted man for hijacking an airliner in 1984. Now, before leaving Cuba, Potts has said in interviews that he was looking for closure and hoped that he can convince U.S. prosecutors to give him credit for the 13 or so years he spent in a Cuban prison for the hijacking. Potts had described himself as a revolutionary, and the article points out that in the 60s and 70s, dozens of aircrafts were hijacked during the Cold War and commandeered to communist Cuba. However, by the 1980s, even Cuba had begun to prosecute these hijackers. Potts called himself the homesick hijacker and will take his chances with the legal system back home. Many Chinese internet users found it odd that he will want to hijack a plane in the first place. And now let's take a look at what else they had to say.
He's really not giving this much thought. Does he not understand the severity of hijacking a plane? I think he'll be lucky if he gets to see the light of day again in his lifetime. America also has such hot-blooded youths. They have such an amazing country to live in, yet they would give it up all to move to Cuba simply because it's a communist country. He's saying this now. I think maybe he was even a spy sent to Cuba by the U.S. government. Does he think it is so easy to become Che Guevara? Hot-blooded youngsters always talk about revolution in an idealized world. Not everyone can become real heroes. This is what people in China call having nothing to do on a full stomach. I guess he can look forward to make jail time when he heads back to America. I am really curious as to how Americans felt towards Cuba in those days. I know he is not the only person to have hijacked a plane. What were they thinking?
According to an article from Sina Finance, the number of government officials in China that have become fugitives on the run increased dramatically over the last few years. According to the article, from the year 2000 to 2011, more than 18,000 Chinese government officials have escaped the country after embezzling large amounts of government funds. It's also estimated that the total amount of money that these fugitives have funneled to offshore accounts and to foreign countries are upwards of 1.5 trillion yuan, or roughly $200 billion, a number that many Chinese internet users believe is a very conservative estimation. Now, some of the most popular destinations for Chinese fugitives are the U.S. and Canada. Canada especially is known as a safe haven for the rich Chinese. And one of the most famous Chinese fugitives, Lai Changxing, had lived in Vancouver, Canada for 12 years before he was extradited back to China to face criminal charges.